Hi, I'm Leah O'Keefe. I'm a senior associate lawyer at Maurice Blackburn, and I specialise in occupational lung disease, silica, and asbestos-related diseases. I'm a specialist accredited personal injury expert, and I've worked in this space for nearly 10 years.
Hi, I'm Ross Attili, and I'm a lawyer in our asbestos and occupational diseases department here at Maurice Blackburn. I've worked in this area for about 4 years.
So, are you eligible to make a claim? That's the age-old question. Essentially, if you've been diagnosed with a lung disease that's being caused or contributed by your previous work, then it's possible and likely that you'll have compensation entitlements. There are time limits around making claims, so we really encourage people to get in contact with a lawyer as soon as possible so you can understand where you stand, get some proper advice, and then take further steps from there. Even though there's time limits, there's very often things we can do, even if it's a really long time since you've been diagnosed, a really long time since you worked or been exposed, because that's really normal in occupational lung diseases, and even if you've been exposed to other substances along the way as well. We really encourage you to contact a lawyer if you want to make a claim. And the reason for this mainly is in order to get detailed advice that will relate specifically to your individual circumstances, make sure you're fully informed about your rights and your entitlements, get the right paperwork going, and get good advice up front. When you contact a lawyer, it's very common that there'll be no obligation from the first appointment. And most lawyers in this space work on a no-win, no-fee basis, which means you shouldn't have to pay anything up front. So you should feel comfortable that you can ask all the questions in the initial appointment to understand how things are going to work moving forward. The legal test for if you're eligible for compensation and the types of things that you're entitled to is different in every state and territory in Australia. So meeting with somebody in your state and territory will give you the information that relates specifically to you.
A question that Leah and I get asked quite a lot from clients is, am I eligible to make a claim if there may be more than one cause of my disease? And in answer to that, look, the law takes into account that diseases can have more than one contributing factor. So even if there is more than one cause of the disease, you may be able to receive compensation. For example, if a person has been a previous smoker, they may be able to receive compensation if we can show that their exposure in their workplace was a contributing factor to their disease. So if you make a claim, what are you entitled to? Well, the compensation you may be entitled to receive will depend on several factors, and that includes how you're exposed to the hazard, whether at home or at work, the state or territory where you're exposed, the type of disease and level of disability that you have as a result of your exposure to the hazard, and whether you were a Commonwealth employee at the time of exposure, such as military or Navy personnel. And although it does vary, the compensation entitlements usually include or cover the following. So a pain and suffering or a statutory lump sum for permanent impairment. And in some instances, you may be eligible for both. Loss of wages or profits. Care for nursing and home help services, including costs for childcare. And medical expenses and treatment costs.
The process for making a claim, again, differs in every state and territory in Australia. We have state-based workers' compensation schemes, and I think the Land Foundation actually has a national directory if you want to look up the relevant statutory authority in your state. But the best thing to do is speak to a lawyer who specialises in occupational lung disease. They'll be able to bring along the right forms to get you started and give you advice to make sure you've got all the information you need to take the next step. Lawyers who specialise in occupational lung diseases and work in this space understand the toll that an occupational lung disease can have on the person suffering from it, as well as their carers and their family. We do our very best to work with you and keep things as simple as possible and help you as much as we can during this difficult time.
Timeframes will depend on your personal circumstances. In certain circumstances, some forms of compensation support may be accessed quickly, for example, basic entitlements to wage replacement, income support, and medical expenses. In circumstances where a person is very unwell, there are mechanisms to fast-track the claim.
If you're in the unfortunate situation where you're halfway through a compensation claim and your health declines and you pass away, then in most states and territories, there are mechanisms to make sure that you're not disadvantaged by this happening so urgently. There is a distinction though that is made in most states and territories in this space around what disease you have and whether that's a disease caused by dust exposure or another type of occupational lung disease, for example, one that might be caused by exposure to a chemical. The reason for this is the history of special rules around asbestos diseases, but it applies in most states to more broadly to dust diseases. With those types of claims, if you pass away during the course of the compensation claim, then the entitlement to your pain and suffering damages is protected as long as a lawyer has taken a couple of simple steps in your lifetime. So it's another reason that it's really important to get onto somebody as soon as you can. Even if it's not in relation to a dust disease, then there are mechanisms to fast track claims, to expedite processes, and to do our very best to make sure that everything's finalized within your lifetime.
So your workplace is likely to be informed if you make a compensation claim. If they are your current employer, usually the initial claim must be provided to them so that they can inform their insurer. In all states and territories, there are protections in place to safeguard employees from discrimination and unfair dismissal following the lodgement of a compensation claim.
If you're the dependent of a person who's already passed away from an occupational lung disease, then you also may have compensation entitlements that you can access. If you can demonstrate the legal tests that are required for this type of claim, then often there's a type of statutory dependency lump sum payment that's paid to somebody who was dependent on a person's earnings who passed away from a condition caused by their work. Some of the things that can be accessed through this claim include the lump sum, a pension entitlement for the partner of the person or their dependent children, counselling on bereavement services, as well as reasonable funeral expenses. Again, the entitlements are different in every state and territory. So if this is a position that you're in, it's best to contact a lawyer.
So compensation systems are designed to provide support to the person living with the occupational lung disease. Unfortunately, this means that carers cannot usually access compensation directly.